Good morning, Professor Carr. Congratulations.
Come on in.
In here?
Mm-hmm. Hello from UC Berkeley, where we are incredibly excited to share in the news that Professor David Card has been awarded the Nobel Prize.
As chancellor, I couldn't be more proud of Professor Card and his colleagues in the Department of Economics. And you may know what's coming next. Yes, Professor Card, in addition to your Nobel Prize, I'm pleased to award you a highly coveted parking space near your office.
Where we take x bar b minus x bar a.
So I first got interested in economics. At the time, I was a physics major, and my girlfriend was taking a introductory economics class, and she was having some trouble with the math concepts in introductory economics, and she asked me to give her a hand, and I started reading the book and spent a couple of nights and read the whole book, or most of the book, and got interested in seeing whether I could take an economics class.
Hi, Professor.
Hi.
Very congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much. Very nice of you to come by.
I'm very happy. Still can't believe. Yeah.
Well, just goes to show, I guess, that, you know, somebody has to win.
Yeah.
There's people that win the Nobel Prize that are quite extraordinary, and I just don't think of myself quite in that category. So, you know, I'm just kind of an ordinary guy.
He's one of my main advisors. Every time that we schedule a meeting for 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes, we end up talking about 1 hour, 1 hour and a half. And I think that's something that happens with most students. Once you get time to talk to him, he really cares about the details. He really cares about what you're doing.
I should have asked you right off the top, but what was your initial reaction when you heard early this morning that you had won?
Well, I have an old friend in Canada that I've known since high school, and this is the kind of joke he would play. So I thought actually that it said there was a message on my phone at home here in Berkeley, and it said it's like Lars from Sweden. And I thought, this has to be Tim.
Where beta hat A and beta hat B were the same.
If you're motivated primarily because you want people to pay attention to what you're going to do, you're going to have a very sad life. That's not really something that it's not one of my primary motivations. You know, in reality, you're doing this for, you know, the scientific value of it and for the future of the scientific knowledge that we're going to build. You're really hoping to influence the next generation.